Hi, everybody. It's a wee bit of alchemy. I'm Rick Barrett. Welcome. A question comes up fairly often and did recently, and I'd like to explore that a little bit. The question is, how do I think of all these things at once? Because I introduce a lot of different ideas in this call. And the things that one can bring one's attention to, one's awareness toward in your Tai Chi form, in your Qigong, or just in daily life, and how do and all of them have some part to play in the overall working of the to make it. Bring it into wholeness to make something happen. And so the question is, how do I remember to do all these things while I'm doing my Tai Chi form, say? That seems like a lot of thinking. And it is a lot of thinking. And the short answer is you don't remember all that. You don't try to think about everything at once. And what we're moving toward is being able to know without thinking. That is, you're able to understand what needs to be done without necessarily having to spend a lot of rational thought on that very topic. So, in other words, if we say, if I say to point and reach with your index finger, that's a, okay, that is a thing, and it's something that I'm hoping you'll do it often enough that it takes root in your awareness, and it doesn't require a whole lot of conscious attention to make it happen. But the only way to get there is by doing it, by actually putting in the effort, by making it important enough to make that happen, which point that will kind of seep into your awareness, your body mind, in a way that allows you to get it whenever you're in that superconscious state. So the idea is that to make superconscious a starting point for our practice, that is, be able to move into that state of heightened body mind integrate body mind spirit integration as our starting point, and then just continue to elevate from there. And as I've mentioned many times, the entry point in it is by bringing your conscious awareness to your sensory feelings. You want to actually feel your body in a way that you're bringing your mind to it, and you're not thinking about, let's say, my finger touching my thumb, but to actually feel that, and to allow that to go through my entire nervous system, so my body mind gets a vivid memory of what that feels like. And the intensity with which we approach this, the desire, has a lot to do with whether or not it sticks or not. If it's something that, it's abstract, you think, oh yeah, I got that. It's probably not going to hang around for you. But if you say, no, I'm going to do this, and to really put some intention and attention, topics we talked about last week, to it and say, yes, I want to make this happen, then it has more likelihood to take root in your awareness. And so it's there to use whenever you need it. So the key to these practices is you pick out one thing, something that you want to work on. Let's say it's Sung Kwa. You want to get very sung, that is, you're releasing into your hips, you're relaxing the connected relaxing the muscles, the tense muscles around the hip joint so that you're able to allow the hip to move freely. So whenever it's swung like that, that's on your mind. You're saying, okay, I'm going through my whole form and I'm going to keep bringing that up, but that bringing that to my conscious awareness. And that requires a certain amount of mental effort to make that happen. But as you do it, as you get comfortable with that, then it's like, okay, I got just the fact of doing it, of becoming aware of that conscious feeling, you bring yourself more and more into the present moment. It brings you more and more into a superconscious state. So superconsciousness then feeds into more superconsciousness, and then you just keep building up from that till it becomes the state itself, as insubstantial as it is, becomes a touchstone for you, becomes a solid foundation on which you build. And so that anytime you go into the superconscious state, then you have these awarenesses, these skills, these abilities, these memories that are available to you in that superconscious state. And one of the problems that people have when they start playing around with this superconsciousness, at least at the beginning, is that it's a different operating system than your conscious mind. It works differently. You don't think about things in the same way to get the idea. It's a learning how to, as I said before, like know without thinking. So you just get it. The idea, it pops up. And that comes from this establishing a deep sense, I guess a felt sense of what these things are as we're doing them and taking them deeper, deeper, deeper. And in your practice, you bring that same level of intensity to your practice, that same attention and intention that we do in these exercises, so that you can actually feel that. And that way you can go and take the tiniest little bit of movement of any kind of ability you want to work on, and just really bring your mind into that. And in so doing, you're creating new neural connections in your nervous system, and that makes it much easier to inculcate these abilities. And it's very different than muscle memory. This is you actually want to be present. It's not something you do and you repeat it often until it becomes habitual. This is something that you become so familiar with, so conversant with, it becomes your friend, your ally, that it's always there whenever you are in that state. So we take these things, these little abilities that I share with you, and we work on that and take it nice and deep so that you get that really felt sense of it. And then you play with it on your own till you get becomes more and more available. But I encourage you to always start by getting into that superconscious state and then go from there. So one thing I'd like to address today now is something that Jonathan mentioned, and we touched on it last week, and I mentioned a lot, but I'd like to go a little deeper into it so we can do that very thing. That is, bring it deep into the deep part of your awareness, into the body mind, so that it becomes a reliable ally. And this one in particular is tricky because it violates what you naturally want to do. It goes against your tendencies. And even if you understand it in the abstract, until you've actually tested it and played with it and really get it so that it's a reliable ally, you're not going to be able to use it in whenever it's important to do so. And the thing I'm talking about here, it's something that's very rarely talked about in the literature, or if at all, and that is the ability, the reaching with the wrist. That's something I talk about. Okay, reach with your wrist, and what does that mean, and how do we get to that point where you're able to separate the reaching with the wrist from shoulder tension? Because this is probably one of the biggest issues that people have is tense shoulders, something that you can tell people, thousand times to relax your shoulders, relax your shoulders. And okay. And then it goes back up again because it is happening at a preconscious level. So this process of superconscious creating these new patterns and getting your body to like these new patterns starts to change something that you've been carrying around with you your whole life. That is a tendency to initiate motion with your shoulders. And it's something that is pretty universal unless you're trained to do otherwise. And so the idea here is to get so familiar with with reaching with the wrist, reaching with the elbow, so that we're able to disconnect from the shoulder and be able to go there in a thought and in a heartbeat. So let's stand up and let's play with that a little bit. Into your three pillars. So this does the work for us of getting us into that superconscious state. You feel the balls of your feet, feel the floor with the balls of your feet. Press down with your toes, feel them very lightly. Feel your heel on the floor too. We're centering over the balls of the feet for the time being, particularly along the insides of the feet. And feel yourself sinking down, relaxing your leg muscles, and just being able to allow yourself to get very sung, drop down into the earth. This allows the earth chi, the yin chi of the earth, to rise up through the feet. It also allows us to dump out extraneous energies that we no longer need. We can ground things. Now reach with the crown of your head. Tuck in the chin. And do that while still maintaining that sung in your legs. Think down. So by reaching with the crown of the head, we open to the yang qi of the heavens. Tuck in the chin and open your jade pillow gate at the base of your skull. This allows your spirit of vitality, your Jing Shen, to rise into your brain and nourish your brain. Feel your quad just nice and easy, kind of rotate by just very, very gently sinking down into your hips. And turning this, relaxing down into your quad, getting very sung quad. Point and reach with your index fingers. Wiggle them a little bit, and just really establish a firm contact through your body. You're not thinking about your fingers, you're feeling your fingers. And immediately feel the sense of fullness and tingling that happens in your hands when you do that. Reach with your elbows, reach out a little bit so your elbows are not collapsed, they're just kind of a very slight curve. Now This opens up the shoulder joints. This gets that process started. Place the tip of your tongue on the roof of your mouth and breathe through your nose. Come a little closer. So to start, I want you to use your left hand and put it under your right wrist. And just lift the wrist and let your fingers hang. Let your elbow drop. Relax your shoulder. Just let that whole thing hang. So this is like really getting very, very soon. Okay, we're releasing down, and just, if I were to take my left hand away, my arm just drops. Okay, that's how relaxed I want that to be. Because what we're doing is we're creating a contrast from our normal state of operation. And just boom, that just relax. Okay. Creating a contrast so that in this very relaxed state, you can actually feel that your shoulder is not engaged. There's no muscular tension there, or very little. Okay, and then let your hands come down. And so by way of contrast, I want you to reach out with your fingers, straighten them, and reach forward with your whole arm, keeping your arm straight. And just very slowly notice what's going on in your arm as you do that. What's going on in your shoulder? Note what's happening, the muscular tension in your whole body. Bring your arm up, just above your head. And feel that. Keep that arm straight. And just feel into how much effort it takes to make that happen. And now bring it down, keeping it straight. Just make a mental note of how much work it required to make this happen. Now we're going to do the left hand. Straighten the fingers. Keep the arm straight and reach nice and slow. Keep that arm straight and feel the work that your arm has to do, your shoulder has to do to make that happen. Bring your arm up just above your head. Hard to even straighten my arm like that, but do that. Just feel the tension in that, and slowly bring it down, keeping the arm straight. Yeah. Now take your right hand and put it under your left wrist and keep your left elbow down. Just pick up let your fingers hang. Let that left arm get very soft, very relaxed. Take the hand away and just let it drop. That's how empty that arm wants to be. And just contrast that to the effort it took to reach out with that straight arm. And let that go down. Now bring your your actually just reach under your right wrist with your left hand and bring that up to about chest height. And now, very slowly, let your left hand move away. Release some of the support that you're giving it very slowly, and take that over with your right arm without tensing up your shoulder. So you want to hold the position with your right arm without tensing up the shoulder. So you just want it to hang there. So this is very sung, right? So what we've done here is we've gotten rid of the muscular tension that is we ordinarily would associate with this kind of movement, this kind of posture, and we're letting the connective tissue do the work. There are muscles that are involved, but they are in a very passive, you're using them very passively right now. So now just reach forward with your right hand just a couple of inches without, with as little effort as possible. And then pull back. And reach forward. Reach forward a little farther. And pull back. And bring your right arm down. You just feel in your arm, your right arm, and just notice the energy that's moving through that, and feel the blood circulating as you release and allow that the tissues in your arm to unwind. And my right arm feels longer than my left right now. And I'm going to bring the right arm under the left wrist, bring that up. Just feel that. It's good to do this on both sides. So it's not just a concept. You want your body to feel that. The hemispheres of your brain work on the opposite side. So right now with my left wrist, I'm working with the right side of my brain. And so it's a different circuits there than with the left side of my brain. I want to give my nervous system a chance to catch up to what I'm thinking conceptually. Very slowly, remove the support and just let your left hand hang. Just let it be the minimum amount of effort it takes. And feel into your shoulders. And feel shoulder tension is gone. It's absent from your body right now. You gently reach forward a couple of inches. Minimum amount of effort. And pull it back. Reach forward a little farther, a couple of inches farther. Notice if your shoulders want to take over the conversation and just say, no, don't need you. This is doing just fine. And come back. Notice that through all this, your mind is clear. You're calm, you're centered. You're in a superconscious state. So we're developing these skills while in a superconscious state, creating these new awarenesses in that superconscious state. And so let your arm relax down. Now, reach up with your right wrist, keeping your elbow down, shoulder relaxed. And now reach forward with your wrist till it comes out just a few inches. And notice that there is an adjustment that has to be made at this point. And that is, you want to get your elbow involved. You're bringing some awareness from the wrist now, and you're going to reach out with your elbow. That opens up the shoulder a little more, be able to extend farther forward. You want to reach out so that your arm is about 90% out there. You're reaching with your elbow. You're also reaching with your wrist. And you want to feel your index finger too. So we got several things going on here, but they're kind of blended into one overall kind of motion. We have index finger creates this tensegrity and connected and energetic coherence. Reaching with the elbow opens, it sets up a real stable post there, which allows the wrist to extend even farther. Now reach very slowly with your fingers and extend. You want to feel that you're reaching, it goes all the way back through your shoulder into your shoulder blade, but you're releasing the muscular tension as you do that. Reach down with your elbow, bend your wrist. Set your elbow and bring your wrist out to the side. Feel the connective tissue opening up as you do that. Feel the energy in your arm. Slowly raise the fingers and reach out. And open. You feel something in your shoulder, but it's not exactly the same muscular tension that you would ordinarily get, what we got whenever we just lifted our arms straight out. And drop your elbow. Reach up with your fingers and bring your wrist down. Now I know my right arm is longer. Let's do it with the left arm. Reach up with the left wrist. And let everything hang. Very soon. Reach forward a couple inches. Reach back. Using the least amount of effort you can. Feel that index finger, reach with the wrist. Now reach with your elbow, extend forward, open. Arm is out there about 90%. 90%. Reach with the fingers. Fingers come up, extend. Feel your back opening up. Feel your scapula. Drop your elbow, drop your fingers. Reach with your elbow, reach with your left wrist and extend, reaching out, opening. Feel the shoulder joint opening up. Feel the tissues lengthening as you do that. Reach with the fingers. Relax as much as you can. Reach down with your elbow. Lift the fingers and reach down with the wrist. Let's do it together. Just reach with the wrist. Relax your fingers. Reach with your elbows and open, extending out. Reach with the fingers. Find your center equilibrium, settle over your, sink into your feet. Releasing any extraneous shoulder tension. Reach down with your elbows, wrists, raise the fingers. And just feel into that posture there, just with the fingers raised. Reaching down with the elbows, down with the wrists. And bring the wrists, the fingers down, reach up with the wrists, and let the fingers hang. And just feel the difference there. You have two different energies occurring there. Reach out, wrists drop, fingers come up. Wrists come up, fingers drop. Fingers up, wrists up. Hands come down. Reach down with your elbows. Down with your wrists. You feel them unwinding. Feel the chi. Feel the blood circulating. Going to reach with the elbow, reach with the wrist, reach with the fingers, reach with the elbow, reach with the wrist, reach with the fingers. Elbow, wrist, fingers, elbow, wrist, fingers. And just get just do that nice and smooth, and just get the feeling of your arm in this wave-like motion. This is deceptively powerful, your arm moving like this. It's much more powerful than a stiff arm reaching out. And learning to have this smooth, supple, graceful motion is really important to adding internal power to your kung fu. And relax and just feel into that. Reach with your left elbow, left wrist, fingers, elbow down, wrist down, fingers, elbow, wrist, fingers, elbow, wrist, fingers, elbow, wrist, fingers, elbow, wrist, fingers. And your right arm and your left arm. Your right arm and your left arm. Yeah. Sink into your left foot, spiral down to the left. You're sinking to the left quad, step out with your right foot. Then sink into your right foot. Feel your right heel, set the right knee. Sink into that and reach with your right elbow, your right wrist. Fingers are relaxed. And turn your body. And as you do that, reach with the wrist. Reach with the fingers. If you extend out with the left hand, you see it like it's a slant flying, diagonal flying. Think into your right. Reach down with your elbows. Pick up your left foot and step out with the left foot. Push your left knee out, set that. Reach with your left elbow. Set the elbow and reach with the wrist. Fingers are relaxed. Reach with the fingers. Reach down with your right hand. Once you get your right foot, step back with your left foot. Bow down to the left and think of your then sink into your right foot and then turn. Elbow, wrist, fingers. Step, elbow, wrist, fingers. Step of the right foot, elbow, wrist, fingers. Feel that extension. Feel your shoulders are very soft, very relaxed. Step back and pivot out your left heel, barrel down, stay in your left foot, Reach up with your right elbow, set that right wrist, and reach up with your fingers. Reach down with your left hand. We have a white crane. Step back with your right foot. Think of your right, spiral down. Left elbow, left wrist, left fingers. White crane. Think of your left foot, spiral down. Right elbow, right wrist, fingers. Left elbow, left wrist, fingers. Back. Elbows, wrists, fingers. Notice that it's not the same pattern each time, it's depending on what the motion is. But in this one, let's say we're just opening a Tai Chi form, it's up. Reach with the wrists. Reach with the elbows. Reach with the fingers. Open up between your scapula. Feel that. Reach with your elbows. Reach down. Reach with your wrists. Fingers come up. Hands come back. Go to the balls of your feet, reach with the elbows, reach with the wrists, reach with the fingers, elbows, wrists, fingers. This time initiate it with the wrists. Go to the balls of your feet, reach with the wrists. Reach with your elbows. Reach with your fingers. Reach down with your elbows, down with your wrists, down with your fingers. Step in. Take a deep breath, inhale. On the balls of your feet and exhale, sink into your heels. Great. Please have a seat.
How'd that go? Good, good. Okay, not too much, huh? Okay, good. Any thoughts? Valerie.
Dude,
Dude. Dude.
I got overwhelmed. I had so much stuff flowing. I stepped aside, tried leaning up against the wall, then I finally laid on the bed.
Wow.
Oh, yeah. I was flying. And
Wow.
that's not even the word flying. It was just extremely powerful.
Wow.
Extremely powerful for me. It was very cool.
Very cool. Oh, good.
And I was
Okay.
able to step back in and, go with it without, okay, I have to lay down again. I needed that. Obviously, I really needed that.
Cool. Great. Well, that, thanks for sharing that. That's good. Good to know.
I'm still alive. I'm
Still alive. Okay.
breathing. Yes.
But
I'm
that
very
is
relaxed.
going through a lot of tension with the wrapping up work and everything. So you may have been holding a lot of something in your shoulders, and this just allowed it to move.
Yep, that's what I reckon.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, it's good. Good. Release the floodgates.
It
Cool.
flooded.
Good. Debbie.
I didn't have quite the intensity of a response that Valerie did, but I was really glad you did both sides, because it wasn't just that my right side initially was longer, it was two sizes bigger than the left side. And that really helped, I think, the energy to start flowing through a lot more. It was pretty intense. That was so. Thank you for doing both sides.
Happy to do it. Good. Good. Scott.
Comment and a question.
Okay.
So yeah, so I definitely was feeling something in my shoulders, but like you said, it was different.
Yeah.
But it was something was working there that doesn't normally work, and it was weird.
Nice.
And do you think
I mean, you make a good point there, and I like to
ahead.
just follow up on that just a little bit, just because when you're first doing something like this, it's hard to differentiate between your muscles and your sinews, and it all just feels like stuff. And to be able to make that distinction, that's why really isolated it so that we kind of sneak up on it, and you're able to make this fine distinction that would ordinarily just appear to the mind as muscular tension. And so that I'm glad you picked up on that, because that's a real key point to why we did it the way we did it. We really want to isolate this, and we're really fine-tuning awareness of what's going on in the body, because one, the sinews is what we want to cultivate, and the muscular tension, we want to kind of tone that down as much as we can. And so, but unless you're able to distinguish between the two, it's harder to train that. So what's the question that you had?
So, my knees were killing me standing
Oh.
there, and I get the feeling that it was too much energy through trying to get through the blockages. That's kind of what it felt like. So,
Yeah.
do you have any thoughts on that?
I'd say whenever that happens, don't be a hero. Just shake it out, and let the energy move along. So you can and then go back and continue. So
Well,
I
at least
think
we.
that if you get like a standing wave there, then it goes like that, and then your body perceives that as pain. And so shake it out and let the energy move along, and then you can see if there's any actual, physical torment going on there.
Well, once we started moving, then it completely went away.
Right. So yeah. So I'd say that not just you, but anybody, watching. There's a lot of teachers will say, no, you got to tough it out. This is you got to work through, feel that pain. You got to, and I'm like, nah. That's not that's not helping. Let's shake it, let it go, and then go back and resume, and sort of a kind of a way woo way kind of approach to it. Cool.
Thank you.
Anybody else? Lynn.
At the beginning, when we were just, holding the arm and then moving, I was so relaxed. I was just about falling asleep. I mean, literally, I was like, my eyes were closing on me, and I'm like, wait, I have to like open them up because I was not collapsing my arms or anything. Everything was still full, but I was just like, ah, so relaxed.
That's great.
Kind of weird. Yeah.
Cool. Thank you. Cool. Anybody else? Sharon.
I think it just brought to me an acute awareness of my shoulders because just as we're sitting here for these last couple of minutes, I could feel the tension building, and I don't usually sense that. And by being aware of it, I could let it go.
Beautiful. Beautiful. Yeah. Great. So it just kind of fits in with, what I was talking about at the beginning there. Once, if you really have this deep kind of impression, deep awareness of these things, then it's much easier to notice when it's not right. Notice when, like, oh yeah, okay, this is what I have to make an adjustment here. The red light flashes and you make an adjustment and get it back on course. Cool. Yeah, Scott.
One other thing I noticed was I had to keep, not through the whole thing, but at points I had to really just let everything go sung. It was, I had to let keep dropping it because it everything was come, all the energy, everything was coming up. So I just had to, just sung everything. And yeah, and every time I did, it was another wave of energy. It was like, whoa.
Cool. Are you signaling you want to say
Oh,
something?
no.
No, you're just reaching. Okay.
No, well, when you said to reach with your fingers and reach with your arm like this, I didn't feel any tension in my shoulder because I was really reaching and I was opening the shoulder.
Okay. Yeah. So no, good point. Yeah, because once you get the joke, then you can reach out with a straight arm and do it with a relaxed shoulder, but it takes a while to get that totally swung there. I was going to say something. Oh yeah. Ideally, you work with a partner, and so you can have your reach your arm out like that, and just so you can, have your partner press down and feel the solidity of the posture without locking up your shoulder. So in other words, you're reaching up, and you can get it so then you're and you can do it if you don't have a partner, just do it yourself. Just kind of you're reaching up with your wrist and pressing down with your fingers, and so you can feel the power that comes with that because you're working with chin rather than Li with that, that muscular tension. And then you try the same thing by point your reach out with a straight arm and just notice what that feels like. And just try that right now. Just actually just try it. Reach out with a straight arm and press down and just feel what that how that acts up in your shoulder then. And now reach out with your wrist and then press down and notice how the there is a you get that soft power from that. So you're actually getting it's better with a partner because then you're not fooling yourself. You have getting some feedback from somebody because it's deceptively powerful, much more powerful than a than the muscular tension. So, yeah, Scott.
It just reminded me of one more thing I noticed is that it's much harder on my dominant arm because my dominant arm is used to tensing up and tightening up all the time. Right? But I can do it much easier with the left than with the right.
Interesting. Cool. I don't think that's true for everybody, but that's
No?
cool. Yeah. What about you, Richard? What do you got?
I was just noticing how helpful it is to me to actually be in class because I'm watching myself on my Zoom camera and I
Nice.
can pay attention to whether my shoulder stays down or not.
Nice. That's great.
Can you Zoom yourself if you don't have a mirror?
I'm sure there are
I'm sure
apps
there are.
for that.
You
Yeah.
develop an alter ego.
Yeah. You can always use your phone and just turn it around so you're doing a video of yourself.
Right.
Cool. Okay, well, thank you all so much. It's been great. And
Thank you. Thanks,
yeah.
Maria.
So
Yeah. Thank
bye.
you, Maria.
Thanks,
Love you.
Maria.
Thank you, everyone.
Bye-bye.
Bye. Bye.